conducting materials.
Part 1.
Let's try to understand. All the electrical engineering materials are classified into conducting materials, insulating materials, semiconducting materials, magnetic materials, structural materials, and refractory materials. Further, the conducting materials are subdivided into following, those is low resistivity and high resistivity. Now you must know that the low resistive material means it is naturally a high conductive, and if it is a high resistive, definitely it should be a low conductive material. This is what you have to understand. Let's continue. If you see that conductor, semiconductor, insulator, there's a big difference between their energy gap diagram, or you can say the energy level diagrams. If you see here, normally we have three bands, as you all know that, you'll all know that, conduction, energy gap, valence bands. Like conduction, energy gap, valence band, conduction band. Here you can see there's no energy gap, is overlap, and the valence band. This is the what you know about it. And for any conduction, you must know that the electron from the valence or the charge should have to reach to the conduction wave for conduction. They have to reach to here for conduction. Here already they have reached, in conductors. So this is a rule. Now let's try to understand what's happening into it. If you see the gap, the energy gap between this insulator, this one is around 6 electron volt, whereas in the conduction of in a semiconductor is around 1 electron volt, but in the case of conductor it is overlap or 0 electron volt. If you try to understand one by one, it is very easy in the conductor, because the free electrons or the valence electron are already reaching into the conduction because they overlapped. Because it is overlapped. Here you can see this is overlap, so electron can easily reach to the conduction band, and thus conduction takes place. In the case of semiconductor, as you know, the gap, energy gap, is around 1 electron volt. Even the small rise in the temperature, above room temperature, the valence band, valence charge carriers, or the electrons can easily jump to the charge carrier, can easily go to the conduction band to conduct the conduction to takes place. When we come to the insulators here, if you see here, the gap is big, right? As I told you earlier, the gap is around 6 electron volt. Now this electron practically find very difficult to jump to the conduction band for conduction, because this is the gap is around 6, it is 6 electron volt, which is very difficult. Even if increasing temperature, go and increase the voltage, nothing happens. In the case like plastic, even it will melt, but you find that no conduction takes place. So this is what you have to understand. Let's go ahead. So here's the band theory, which you can understand. Conductor contains large number of electrons in the conduction band at room temperature. No energy gap exists, and the conduction and the valence band gap overlap. Thus, the electrons are readily available for conduction. Thus, metal has a large conductivity, as energy gap is almost 0 electron volt, as explained to earlier. Whereas, when come to insulator, is a material in which the energy gap is so large that practically no electrons can be given enough energy to jump this gap. So, the conduction becomes difficult, and the energy gap is here how much? It is around 6 electron volt, as I told to you. A semiconductor is a material which is energy gap small enough for electrons to cross rather easily from valence band to conduction band. At room temperature, the sufficient energy available for few valence electrons to cross the energy gap. Thus, the material sustains some electric current. For semiconductor, energy gap is about or around 1 electron volt, or it could be less. Let's try to understand the low resistive material. These materials have very low resistivity. Resistivity of material is in between 1.5 into 10 to minus 8 ohm meter to 3.0 into 10 to minus 8 ohm meter. There is a less voltage gap, or there is a less voltage drop, that is I multiplied by R, and the less power loss is I square R, as the value of electrical devices and other apparatus. These materials are also used for transmission and distribution of electrical energy. Example is a copper and aluminium, because they are low resistive material, less power is utilized or less power is dissipated. Thus, aluminium copper can be used for your power supply or transmission line. The properties of low resistive material. यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड रेजिस्टिविटी एज यू नो दिस मटेरियल है लो रेजिस्टिविटी टेम्परेचर कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस दिस मटेरियल्स है लो वैल्यू ऑफ टेम्परेचर कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस डेंसिटी डेंसिटी ऑफ लो रेजिस्टिव मटेरियल इज कंसिडरेबली लो corrosion this material has less corrosion resistance that you must understand this materials can be solder easily when it comes to contact resistance this material have low contact resistance ductility this materials are ductile okay let's go ahead let's take one by one this low resistive material first one we have taken is copper might be you have seen such pictures somewhere here and there okay this is the some picture of copper you can see this is also copper this is also copper okay let's take some more pictures also you see this is also copper band okay properties of copper first one it is reddish brown in color as you seen next is it is highly malleable and ductile it can be welded at radiate okay it can be soldered easily it is highly resistant to the corrosion its melting point is 1084 that is 1084 degree Celsius. Okay, its electrical resistivity is 1.6 to 82 micro ohm centimeter. Its tensile strength varies from 3 to 4.7 tons per centimeter square. It is a non-magnetic material. Remember this: it is a non-magnetic material. It form useful alloy with other metals easily. Okay, it can be even sometimes mixed with the gold and other materials to make a alloys application. It is used for manufacture in wires. Cables, windings of generator and transformers, overhead conductors and bus bars. Okay, that's about the copper. Let's try to understand aluminum. Many times you see the aluminum very easily. This is the some pictures of the aluminum. You can see, yeah, this is how it looks like. Okay, let's continue. Properties of aluminum. It is silvery. That is a bluish white in color and luster. Okay, luster means shines. It is highly malleable and ductile like copper also. It cannot be soldered or welded easily. Okay, that you have to remember. It is offer high resistance to corrosion. Okay, its melting point is 658 degree Celsius, whereas its electrical resistivity is how much? 2.669 micro ohm centimeter at 20 degree Celsius, which is higher than copper. Yeah, it is light in weight. Its tensile stress is 1.5 tons per centimeter square. Application of aluminium. It is used for manufacturing in overhead transmission line, wire, bus bar, ASCR conductor, and rotor bars of squirrel cage induction motor. In the most of motor, it is used as AC conductor and other. Like copper, also used many times. Okay, let's go ahead. Silver. Wow, this is some picture of silver. You can see this is how silver looks to be. Okay. These are silver coins. Sometimes people buy in the market. Okay, is there? And this is how actually silver looks in crude form. Okay, this is crude form, and then it's can be converted into this form or in jewelries. Okay, let's go ahead. Properties of silver. Silver is a considered costlier than the copper and aluminium. Though silver has greater conductivity than copper, and the cost of silver restricts the application of electrical. Or electronic engineering devices, except for very special cases of instrument, because the cost is that is what it limits. Otherwise, silver is the best conductor one can have. Okay, let's go ahead. Properties of silver: its resistivity at room temperature is 1.629 × 10⁻²² micro ohm meter. Its specific weight is 10.5 gram per centimeter cube. Its melting point is 916 degrees Celsius. Its temperature coefficient of resistance is 0.00 per degree Celsius. It can drawn and it can be rolled into sheets. Its wire strong, rather hard, durable and highly ductile. Okay, so that's about the property. One more, few more properties. Let's try to understand. It has high resistant corrosion. There is no oxidation. It can stand up in damp air and high temperature. That's the reason how the jewelries are made. Its boiling point is 2180 degree Celsius. It can be soldered and welded easily. Application of silver. Though silver has greater conductivity than copper, the cost of silver restricts its application for electrical and electronic engineering devices, except for very special cases of instrument. We use this silver. ओके।